I think for all of us, I don't think there's anyone listening that I would say is an exception to this, that probably our biggest enemy is our own voice in our head.
Absolutely, yeah.
And I call that Billy, the bully, that lives in all of us, because it's graphic, it's easy to remember, mm-hmm. but and that's just our own self-doubt, you know, that we can't, putting limits on ourselves and what we think we can do.
Right.
And once we get past that limiting self-talk, that's where really all the greatness is. And I'll give you the most obvious example in my life. You know, when I started running, I could run 2 miles. My goal was to run 2 miles. And that's what I wrote down on a piece of paper.
Yeah.
And I worked towards that goal. And said, I could do that in 18 minutes. I'm a runner. And fast forward a couple of years later, I ended up running 100 miles nonstop. And nothing changed in my body. It's not like I got stronger. My legs didn't change. Yeah. My lungs are the same ones God gave me. But that the belief that I could do it, the actual belief that I literally could run 100 miles nonstop is what got me there, along with training. But if I was stuck in the world of, okay, 2 miles was enough, I would have never realized that I was capable of 50 times what I thought I was. So now I ask myself all the time, what other areas of my life am I under-indexing in? If I was 50x greater than I thought I was initially,
yeah.
Could my net worth be 50x? Could my relationship with my wife be 50x? Could my health be 50x better? Like, where am I? You know, like, and the only way you know that is stepping into the unknown. You know what I mean? And to me, all the growth in my life, any success, anything, has come from stepping into the unknown, not necessarily pain, not going, it's going into areas. It could be like, okay, record deal. I'm going into the office. I have no idea what's going to happen. They think I'm Dana Dane. I'm going into, you know, I could just, every example in my life has been like that.